I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Hey everybody, how you doing? Check out my cool fishing hat. I like this hat. It's got some neat features in it. It's got a couple ventilation holes so my giant head can breathe. Got the snaps on the side. Got a little chin strap so you can kind of snug it down there. Look like a buckaroo. I kind of like to wear it like that. I don't really like the whole cowboy hat thing, but you know, I need a hat. Big floppy hat protects my big giant ears and keeps my neck from being more red than it already is. Anyway, this hat's not waterproof. It's basically made by Sky. I don't know who that is. Found this at the thrift store for like $1.48. 60% cotton, 40% polyester, made in China. And not a bad hat. I haven't really worn it that much because I have another hat that I like a lot better. But anyway, I thought, hey, it'd be kind of cool to make this waterproof. I want to wax it up and make like a wax hat. I don't want to make an oil cloth or a tin cloth. I'm just going to use wax. Because I don't like the idea of using solvents to waterproof things because they kind of smell and it's a solvent and all that kind of stuff. But what I am going to use, and this is where it gets kind of weird. Look at that. Toilet bowl ring. It's wax. In the olden days, this was beeswax. But beeswax is crazy expensive now compared to the olden days. And so it's a mix. It's basically wax, like vegetable wax, what they call slack wax, which is just basically a mixture of different waxes. A lot of them are kind of petroleum-based. And I kind of went back and forth on it because I do have beeswax. And I also have some candles that are paraffin-based wax. But what I'm thinking is I'm going to use this particular wax right here to give me most of my volume. I'm going to sprinkle a little bit of beeswax in it to make sure it's got the color that I want. I'm going to use maybe just a tiny little bit of paraffin wax. I'm going to use some sweet orange oil to help as a carrier oil. Plus, it kind of has a little bit of a citrus smell. And I'm going to use coconut oil as the primary carrier oil for the wax. Because from what I understand, you mix the oil and the wax together, and it makes the wax easier to apply. It helps to suck into the fabric you're working with. And hopefully, it'll have the same effect of using like a solvent base. Now, people use like turpentine, and they also use boiled linseed oil to make the oil cloth, and there's some inherent risk with that, as in linseed oil can be highly combustible, but I don't like the idea of using a solvent. So I'm going to melt the waxes, my little mix, I'm going to add the carrier oils to it, and then I'm going to take and apply it to the hat. And since it's not my favorite hat, if it doesn't work out right, it's not a big deal. I'm going to use the old double boiler method. I'm going to use this Pyrex bowl or whatever bowl this is. This is what we use a lot for soap and waxes, so it's not food grade. Use my stainless steel. I'm going to put the wax in here. I'm going to melt it down, and then we'll basically apply it to this. So let me take a second, and I'll get right back with you. And it'll only be like half a millisecond. Bye-bye. You know what? I'm probably going to speed this up, so right about now. These are, well, maybe not right now, but these are pretty cheap. They're like $1.48. Okay, and we're back. The wax has been melted. The essential oil has been added. I have a piece of cardboard here to protect everything. I'm going to use this in a liquid form. A lot of people say let it dry. I think a liquid form will get a little bit better. Keep in mind, it's melted wax. It's like lava. Very hot. I have a little foam brush. And I have a regular brush. Both of those came from the dollar store. The blue tape around the bristles is to keep the nylon fake horsehair from coming out. So, okay, let's give this a try. Let me see. I'm going to go with the back first. Kind of see what happens here. Remember, very, very hot. Little, very nice. Smells good. And basically, you just start painting. I'm going to pay attention to the seams. Spread it out as best I can. Cover the whole thing. Yeah. When this thing dries, it should dry white. And then I'll have to use some heat to get it to stick in. It's already starting to cool down a little bit. I may not have added enough oil. We'll see. But anyway, I'm going to set this to fast forward and you guys can watch the rest of it. Alright, well here's what we got so far, a crazy looking really thick waxed hat. I'm going to let this dry completely and then I'll put some heat to it and get it to all absorb into the canvas type material, which is I think 60% cotton, 40% polyester. So now I just got to let it dry. Okay, the hat has had a chance to cool off and dry in the sun, and this right here, this darkening of the canvas is actually caused by the inseam or whatever, I'm not a hat guy, the hat liner. I didn't think that it would bleed through, but evidently this is, you know, painted canvas or something. So, with the heat and the wax and the oil, it sort of bled through to the, you know, the tan canvas up here. So, now, what I would have done, if this was removable or folded down, I would have folded this out of the way and not put anything on it. Or, you know, at least had it separate from the outside canvas. I shouldn't say canvas, it's 60% cotton, 40% polyester. So that the black dye from the inside of the hat band, like I said, whatever this piece is, because here is your hat band right here, bled through. I would have separated it so that it wouldn't have been affected. But I didn't because I couldn't, because it's sewed and it's like attached. You can't, you know, it's attached right here. So that's what the hat looks like now. Now, to be honest with you, I like it a whole lot more now than I did before, man. I like the contrasting color. I like the way it looks, man. I think the hat looks kick-ass. It's individual now. So it's still tan. It's just darker. It's a little bit slightly heavier because it's got the wax and the oil in it to waterproof it. But I like the contrasting color, man. I'm digging it. Now the hat's kind of unique in mine, you know. But I was not expecting that at all. And, you know, some people may be going, man, you ruined that hat. That's, you know, sure, if you think I ruined it, that's cool. But I like it. I like it better now than I did before when I started. You know? So there you go. One more thing about putting the hat in the oven. Coconut oil and wax. I turn the oven on. I let it get to 325. That is between 300 and 350. So you say 325. Once the oven got heated up, then I put the hat in there and then turn the oven off. If I had any of the solvent stuff like turpentine or linseed oil, I wouldn't have done that because I'd probably burn the house down. And then my lady would be very angry with me. But I didn't, so I just let the heat sort of do its thing. But overall, I'm really pleased. I like it a whole lot better. There you go. Bye-bye. I like peanut butter, I like peanut butter, I like peanut butter, peanut butter.